Okay. Alright. So, yeah, my PC's charged, sort of. Alright, here we go. Hi, guys. Welcome back to The Witcher. The Witcher 3. Don't know what part this is, but... Part 17.
I see you gathered it. As Yennefer of Vengerberg told it, there had been a magic explosion in Skeleton. Related to Ciri's reappearance, it had destroyed a vast swath of forest. Geralt set out for the Isles to join the sorcerers and seek further clues of Ciri's whereabouts.
Alexa, set a timer for 20 minutes.
20 minutes, starting now.
Yeah, because that's how long I'm going to be recording this for. Not like an hour, but like 20 minutes or something.
Listen, Richard, there's some weird yabbling, you know, drowners, real problem, the kind your silver sword could most certainly solve.
What's the problem?
Let me guess. They're tearing your nets, devouring your fish, and attacking the occasional lone boatman or tavern patron who walks home along the shore.
Were that the only harm? Terrors in the bay are meaner than on the continent. They hunt come dusk, come dawn. Attack fishermen wielding just oars and warriors alike. Sea tosses them up after. Armor shredded, guts devoured.
Strange. Any witnesses?
Rurik, my apprentice. He was on a boat the Muir Diablin attacked. There's Tove too. Her man was killed. She lives nearby, up a bit. Sorry, none of that comes to mind. Those who see the beasts, meet him. Well, they generally don't come back to dry land alive.
I'll take the job. Dealt with drowners many times. It'll...
Alright, so I got the contract.
Thank you. Bran was a great ruler. He needs a worthy successor. You speak as though you have someone in mind.
Skellige's trouble is very much derived from it not being a hereditary monarchy. Any upstart can be king and destroy his predecessor's legacy.
The King of the Isles is a more symbolic position.
That should change as well. A strong leader who wields true power. That is what the times require.
I'm Geralt.
I'm Geralt, a witcher.
Berna, Queen of Skellige. I'm glad we've met. But you must forgive me. Duty calls.
I can see you chose your own outfit. You know, of course, that together we look about as good as lace frills on a battle axe.
Everyone's got their style. Don't like funerals. Don't like feasts.
I know. You also dislike underdone meat and being teleported. But sometimes we must overcome our disgusts and prevail.
We should mingle before they all get drunk. There'll be no talking to anyone then.
Good thinking. I don't know what Krach wants, but when we meet with him, we should have clear minds.
I'm not gonna drink. Why dull my senses when I'm in such pleasant company?
Do you plan to compliment me all evening?
I plan to tell you what I think.
Wonder if he's as strong as he looks. So, what have you brought for the farewell feast?
Oh,
bread.
Geralt, there's something I've been meaning to ask you. Mm-hmm. Your beard. Why did you decide to grow it out?
Don't really know.
Must say it. Greetings, Arbor. My companion is Geralt of Rivia.
I am honored.
Where can we find?
We wanted to talk to Krach on Crete.
Jarl will join us shortly. He's assigned you a place of honor at the table just beside his daughter, Ceres. Follow me, please.
You've seated us here.
I asked them to. Wanted to meet the notorious witcher, Geralt.
We've met. Don't remember?
That was ages ago. Yalmer and I were children when you last visited Ordor. But you should meet your face mates and lend me the dubious honor. That's Halbjorn, son of Halvor Blackhand, Blue Boy Lucas, Madman Lucas' firstborn, and Chok and Dennis Stockfish over here is Otric on Hindar.
Forgive me, I remember our meeting all those years ago, but I don't recall your name.
Ceres on Crete. Krach, her dad, and her big brother Yalmer, called Sparrowhawk. A Yal's daughter she is. Fat lot of good it does.
Ceres is jealous, for the one among us who performs the greatest feat will be crowned king.
We all know that feats are a sideshow. Our fathers will choose who will wear the crown. What do you think they spoke to Krach about?
You talk like that because you're short of strength and skill. Remember when Hjalmar challenged us all to a race up the mount? You didn't stand with us then. As he buried his axe in that stump at the top to mark his victory, you were warming your chicken bones by the fire.
Had my reasons for not participating, but I would have won then, as I'd win now.
Now that you mention him, just noticed Hjalmar's not here.
My brother walks his own paths. But about the race, why don't we repeat it? I'm willing to challenge any of you, Witcher included. If I beat him to the top, venture to say that'll be a feat, eh? So you in?
If the Witcher is in.
Geralt?
Enough time.
Honored to be asked, but we need somebody tonight.
Shame. Enough with another and let's drink.
Can't today, for good reason, believe me.
But if not today, then when?
You've been great company. Sadly, it's time we moved on.
Really?
Indeed. We must talk, but not here. You shall learn all beyond our door.
Please, sir,
Allow me to introduce Geralt of Rivia, the Witcher. Geralt, Jarl Donar and Hinder, and Jarl Madman Lugos.
Aye, Lugos and Madman's an insult to Madman. He's a common goat fucker.
Call me a goat fucker one more time, and I'll chop off your head, stick it on a pike, and piss down your neck hole.
Enough! Time to settle this. Here and now.
Oh, ha ha ha! Give me a true freak right now. Shack my best trousers. Put that away before you cut yourself, you cunt.
Take this outside.
Settle this outside.
Who the fuck are you to advise me, eh?
Someone with better manners. You insult Bran's memory and craft's hospitality with this. Emperor would be very pleased to hear you call.
His Imperial Majesty is more than welcome to visit.
Let him sail over here. We ain't afraid of the Black Ones.
Raiding coastal villages is one thing. Total war with the Empire is another.
Awfully mighty, this one. Go stir your cauldron and pierce some boils, witch. Don't talk when you haven't got a fucking clue.
Gone too far.
You know what, Lugos? Just realized I don't give a damn about your hallowed rules of hospitality.
Finally, some diversion. And here I was ready to puke from all the boredom. Come on, freak. Show us what you...
Move the benches. There's to be some dog slapping.
about now?
Now we pay a visit to Ermion's laboratory.
Didn't know we'd been invited.
Because we've not been.
Let's go.
Take it Ermion won't be there.
That's right.
And what's the purpose of this visit?
We're looking for an object. The Mask of Erberos. We'll need it. Come, Geralt.
Now you'll tell me why you need this mask.
Oh, I shall. In due course.
Take it, you'll decide when.
Correct. Yes?
Prizes
never end. See the ravens?
Hard not to.
Ermion's spies. An indication that we're near his laboratory. They also sense a clear magic aura. Come, there's a ledge outside this window. We must pass along it.
Seen uglier sights in my life.
Geralt of Rivia, being romantic.
Oh wow, you got terrible.
myself. The door is locked. The animals, they're alive. Yen, watch out. Monsters. Ow. Feel
Alexa, stop.
What's happening?
You were hallucinating.
You ran at Ermion's animals, sword flailing. I had to calm you.
Wait, Element must have looked funny.
Must have looked strange.
Your years of vigorous training at Kaer Morhen finally paid off. Bested nearly all the stuffed beasts in here.
Please.
Fine. We've passed the trial of taxidermy. The door stands open. Let's go inside, Geralt.
Mind save it.
Alright. Alright, guys. If you guys have enjoyed this episode, please like, comment, and subscribe. And as always, I will see you guys on the next one. Bye.